Meantime, the Biden administration has promised 10 million COVID tests to schools every month. But one local superintendent warns it's not that simple. Alicia Roberts is live in Glen Mills with a look at what test to stay programs require and why some schools may be left out. Hi, Alicia.
Hi, Jessica. School leaders worry that this federal effort may attempt to fix a program here, at least in Garnet Valley, that isn't even broken.
It's really given us an advantage in keeping schools open.
Garnet Valley superintendent says he has been able to keep a majority of the district's more than 5,000 students learning in person, especially in the days immediately after winter break, as new cases surge thanks to daily on-site testing.
We kept over 80 students out of our schools who tested positive on that morning.
Test to stay programs are meant to keep students who have been exposed to a COVID positive person but don't show symptoms and test negative in class.
We don't have a local health department, so we are our health department.
But now Dr. Mark Bertrando worries his testing supplies, currently provided through a partnership with CHOP, may be disrupted as the state health department steps in to manage inventory under the Biden administration's initiative to provide 10 million monthly tests to schools nationwide.
How that's going to impact our testing programs, quite frankly, I don't know.
He also warns tests alone aren't enough and that it takes people to oversee these efforts on the ground. Garnet Valley hired 5 temporary nurses.
You need runners to go back and forth to cars. You need folks to watch the test, input the data. So it is labor intensive.
Labor that may be hard to find, especially in districts already facing staffing shortages. And at least for now, here in Garnet Valley, their partnership with CHOP will remain in effect. Testing resumes tomorrow morning at 7:30 a.m. Reporting live in Glen Mills, Alicia Roberts, CBS 3 Eyewitness News.
Alicia, thank you.